Hi all, welcome to the second lecture of Power Electronics. From here onwards, we are starting with our actual syllabus. We are starting with Unit 1. So your Unit 1 consists of SCR, UJT and PUT. We are starting with SCRs. So let us start. Before we start with SCR, let us first see some basic semiconductor devices. The basic one being diode. You have seen a diode, it has got two terminals, anode and cathode. Diode inside it has got two semiconductor layers, P layer and N layer, which make up anode and cathode. Second semiconductor device you have studied is a BJT, which is bipolar junction transistor. It has got three terminals, emitter, base, collector. So here there are three terminals or there are three layers of semiconductor, NPN or PNP, depending upon the type of semiconductor. The new type of device that you are going to study in this unit is SCR, which is called a silicon controlled rectifier, or it is also generally called as thyristor. Diode has got two layers, transistor has got three layers, whereas this has got four layers of semiconductor, PNPN. There are three terminals to this, anode, cathode and gate, which is represented as A, K and G. Now since there are four layers of semiconductors, these four layers form three junctions, junction J1, J2 and J3. So these are the layers of semiconductor present inside the SCR. Now let us see how internally the construction of SCR consists of. So first it has got a threaded stud. This is used to pin this SCR device to some frame or to a heat sink using this threaded stud. Next you have an aluminium plate here which forms anode terminal of SCR. Then you have the four layers, P layer, N layer. To this P layer, there is a gate terminal attached. To the last N layer, you have cathode terminal attached. So here you have junction J1, here is junction J2, here is junction J3. So this is the internal construction of SCR. Next we will see the symbol of SCR. So symbolically, whenever you have to represent or connect this SCR into a circuit, you will use this type of symbol. You see here, this symbol is very much similar to a diode with its anode, cathode, and the only difference here is it has got a third terminal called gate. So this is the symbolic representation of SCR. So overall, a thyristor or an SCR is a four-layer semiconductor device having four layers PNPN, which form three PN junctions J1, J2, J3, and it acts as a switching device. That is, whenever you use this in any of the circuit, it will for some time it will be turned on, for some time it can be turned off. So it acts as an on-off switching device. This is how it looks like physically with its three terminals, anode, cathode and gate. So this is the pin out of SCR. Now let us see how this SCR is connected in a circuit. This is the anode terminal, this is gate terminal and this is cathode terminal connected to a load. Let us say that this is a resistive load for simplicity. It is connected to the supply voltage through a rheostat. And the gate terminal is connected with a small circuitry here, which consists of a DC battery, a variable resistor and a switch here. We will see later why this small circuitry is used. The current which will flow through this thyristor is called as anode current, and the voltage coming across anode and cathode of the thyristor is called as anode voltage VA. So using this circuit diagram of SCR, we are going to study the VI characteristics of SCR. Now, what do I mean by characteristics is that the behavior of this SCR under certain conditions. The characteristics of SCR will be defined in three modes of operation. The first mode is reverse blocking mode. Second mode is forward blocking mode. Third mode is forward conduction mode. In first two modes, the SCR is off. In the third mode, the SCR can be turned on. Now, how does that take place? That we will see in detail using this circuit. So first, let us see the first mode of conduct, the first mode of operation, that is reverse blocking mode. In this mode, anode is given negative terminal of the supply, cathode is given positive terminal of the supply. So cathode is at higher potential as compared to anode, and gate is not connected yet. What this symbol represents is this small circuitry consisting of switch, variable resistor and this DC supply. This circuitry is not yet connected to the gate. So that is represented by this open switch. Now you see here, layer P is given negative terminal. So here junction J1, which is formed by P and N, will be reverse biased. Also, this N layer has got positive terminal here. So junction J3 will be also reverse biased, whereas junction J2, N is given negative, P is given positive. So junction J2 is forward biased. So your junction J1, J3 are reverse biased, junction J2 is forward biased. Now because cathode is connected to positive terminal, there will be a small leakage current flowing from cathode to anode. And this leakage current is called as reverse leakage current, since it is flowing from cathode to anode. So this is what happens in reverse blocking mode. Next is forward blocking mode. In forward blocking mode, anode is given positive terminal. That is, this anode terminal of SCR will be given or will be connected to positive terminal of the supply, like how it is shown in this circuit. And the cathode terminal will be given negative terminal of the supply, like how it is shown in the circuit. This circuitry is still not connected, that is gate switch is still not connected to the SCR. Now here if you see junction J1, P is given positive, so junction J1 will be forward biased. N is given negative, so junction J3 will be also forward biased. Whereas junction J2, N is getting positive and P is getting negative, so junction J2 will be reverse biased. So here in this case, J1 and J3 are forward biased, whereas J2 is reverse biased. From anode to cathode, there will be a small value of current called as forward leakage current flowing from anode to cathode. So this is what happens in forward blocking mode. And a continuation of this mode, we will study in forward conduction mode. So these three are the modes of VI characteristics of SCR. These three modes will describe VI characteristics of SCR. We will be studying these in detail with the help of graph now. For studying VI characteristics, we will have to take x-axis and y-axis as it is shown here. This is your y-axis, this is your x-axis. For time being right now, just ignore this P and Q. We will see later why this P and Q are coming here. So your y-axis, this part, the positive part, is your positive anode current plus IA. This part is negative anode current minus IA. This part here is plus VA and this part here is minus VA. Now, the first mode, let us consider the first mode. First mode is reverse blocking mode. In reverse blocking mode, anode is given negative terminal of the supply, cathode is given positive terminal, and there is a small current called as reverse leakage current flowing from cathode to anode. So that small leakage current will be represented here, which is starting from zero and then it is going increasing. So you see here in pink color, this is the reverse leakage current. It starts from zero and then as the anode voltage, that is as the voltage across anode and cathode keeps on increasing, the current also keeps on increasing its value. So this is the reverse leakage current which flows from cathode to anode. Because it is reverse leakage current, it is coming in the third quadrant, it is negative value. So this current, we have labeled this current as reverse leakage current from cathode to anode. Now as the current increases and as it reaches here, along with the current, the voltage is also increasing. Because the voltage is increasing, the current is increasing. So as the anode voltage keeps on increasing and it reaches a value here which is called as reverse breakdown voltage, called as VBR, as the anode voltage VA reaches this value, an avalanche takes place in the reverse biased junctions J1 and J3, and because there is avalanche taking place, the current starts increasing rapidly, and this current is represented by PQ. So in this mode, what happens? Reverse leakage current keeps on increasing as the anode voltage keeps on increasing, that we have labeled here as reverse leakage current. As the voltage increases and reaches to a value called as reverse breakdown voltage VBR, avalanche takes place in reverse biased junctions J1 and J3, and the current increases rapidly, which is shown by PQ. So this region is called as reverse avalanche region, because in this region avalanche takes place and your reverse leakage current keeps increasing. So this region represented by PO, this is called as reverse blocking mode. Now there is one thing to be noted here. As the current keeps on increasing here, the voltage value is remaining same, but the current is keeping on increasing. You can see here the current keeps on increasing. As the current increases, the temperature also will keep on increasing. The temperature of the device will also keep on increasing. And if the temperature keeps on increasing, it will damage the SCR at some point. So it should be noted, it should be taken care that the anode voltage does not cross this value, does not reach this value of VBR, just in order to protect our device. So this is what happens in reverse blocking mode. In this mode, anode is given negative, cathode is given positive terminal of the supply, gate is not connected, J1 and J3 are reverse biased, J2 is forward biased, there is a small reverse leakage current flowing. So this is your first mode. In the second mode, we have anode connected to positive terminal, cathode connected to negative terminal, gate is still not connected. Now here, P is connected to positive, so junctions J1 and J3 will be forward biased, as we have seen earlier in the last slide. J2 will be reverse biased, and there will be a small value of current called as forward leakage current flowing from anode to cathode. So this current you will be able to see, which is increasing from zero in green color and reaching a point here. So as the anode voltage VA keeps on increasing, the current here also keeps on increasing. So this region, which is represented here, this we have labeled as forward leakage current. And this region, which is represented here in green color, this is called as forward blocking mode. So this is your second VI characteristic, or this is your second mode, forward blocking mode, in the VI characteristics of SCR. Now as the voltage VA keeps on increasing, it reaches to a value which is called as VBO. It reaches to a value VBO, which is called as forward breakover voltage. And once it reaches to forward breakover voltage, junction J2, which is reverse biased, avalanche takes place in J2 and the current increases and it reaches at a point M. Once the current reaches at point M, at this voltage VBO, the thyristor turns on. I'll repeat this. When the voltage VA keeps on increasing, voltage across anode cathode keeps on increasing, the current also increases. And as the voltage reaches this value VBO, which is called as forward breakover voltage, current reaches at a point M here and the thyristor turns on. From this point onwards, from point M onwards, from point M, it directly shifts to another point called as N. It reaches to this point and then your SCR keeps on conducting, which is shown here in blue color. The region is shown in blue color. So this region, which is represented by NK, during this region, your thyristors is turned on, and this region NK is called as forward conduction mode. In this mode, the thyristors is turned on. Whereas in these two modes, reverse blocking mode and forward blocking mode, in these two modes, the thyristor is off. So these are the three modes which describe VI characteristics of SCR. What we study here in VI characteristics is when the thyristor turns off, when the thyristor turns on. So the VI characteristics look like this. Final VI characteristics look like this. We have stated here in the VI characteristics that for turning a SCR on, there are two major conditions required. The first and foremost condition is anode has to be positive, cathode has to be negative. You have seen in the first mode, which is reverse blocking mode, anode was negative, cathode was positive. So in that mode, thyristor was not turning on. Whereas in the second mode onwards, the thyristor kept turning on. So anode has to be always positive, or anode has to be at a higher potential with respect to the cathode. Anode has to be at higher potential, cathode has to be at lower potential. Only then thyristor will turn on. The second most condition which is needed to be fulfilled is voltage across anode cathode. You see here across the thyristor, the voltage across anode cathode of thyristor has to reach a value VBO, which is forward breakover voltage. Only when this VA reaches to VBO, then only the thyristor will turn on. So these two are the conditions which are required for an SCR to turn on. Also, there is an alternative for this second condition. What we can do is we can close this switch, and this supply voltage will provide a DC pulse, which is called as gate triggering pulse. When a gate triggering pulse is applied here by turning on the switch, what will happen? The gate triggering pulse will appear across gate and cathode, and that DC gate triggering pulse will turn on the thyristor. So the second condition can also be a positive gate pulse. When applied at gate and cathode, the thyristor will turn on. But the most important condition is anode has to be at higher potential as compared to the cathode. So these are the conditions which are required for turning a thyristor on. These are some of the applications of SCR. Mainly it is used for switching. It is turned on for some time, then it is turned off. In this unit we will see the methods used for turning on a thyristor and also the methods used for turning off the thyristor. So that is all for this lecture. Thank you.